In this tutorial, we're going to work on making our jumping mechanics better. We're going to add coyote time, which is going to give our players a small window to jump after walking off of a platform. And then we're also going to add jump buffering, which lets players press jump slightly before landing. When we add both of these, it makes our platformer feel a little bit more responsive. These mechanics can solve two frustrations when you're building a platformer or any game which is going to have jumping, where players can press jump slightly too late when running off a platform or slightly too early when falling towards one or falling towards the ground. When these mechanics aren't there, people will feel like the game isn't responding to their inputs correctly, but when implemented well, players never notice them. The game just feels right. So in order to implement them, we need to start in our player script, and we're going to need to add a couple of other variables. The first one is going to be an export variable of coyote time. It's going to be a float. We're going to make this 0.2. This seems to be the best amount of time for this. 0.1 is too quick. 0.3 just seems a little bit too long. And then on top of that, we're going to need to make another variable called wasOnFloor. That's a bool, going to equal false, and another variable called canCoyoteJump, which is a bool, and it also equals false. So wasOnFloor tracks if we were on the floor in our last frame, and the canCoyoteJump is going to track if we can still jump. So the only thing that we're going to need to do in our physics process now is we need to add at the very start is was on floor, it's going to equal is on floor. So before we get into our actual animations, we need to add another check. So we're first going to check if was on floor and the velocity dot y is greater than or equal to zero. And if that's the case, we can coyote jump. So we're going to set that to true. And we're going to get tree. We're going to make a timer, create timer on our coyote time. And then we're going to wait for the timeout. And we're going to connect to func. So we're going to make a one-off function to just coyote jump equals the false. So this is going to be us starting the timer for coyote time when we're walking off of a platform. Then we also need to adjust where we're actually looking for our input action of jump. So we need to check if we're on floor, but this is going to be a grouped. We're gonna compare to is on floor or if we can coyote jump. So one of those two. So if we press jump and one of these two are true, we will be able to coyote jump. But then we also need to set can coyote jump to false after we actually jump. So now when we play this, you can see closely that it allows me to walk a little bit further off the ledge, but if you don't time it right, you're still gonna fall. So it's a little bit hard to demonstrate, obviously, but if you play with it, if you turn it off, you're going to find that it's a lot harder to make this jump. So now let's implement jump buffering, which is going to allow us to jump more quickly when we hit the ground. So we're going to effectively be making our player jump right before touching the ground. So in order to do this, we need to add a couple variables. Export variable of jump buffer time. It's going to be a float, and we're going to use 0.1. We're going to add a variable of jump pressed, which is a bool, and it's going to default to false, and a jump buffer timer, I'm going to assign, but it's going to be of the type timer. Now in our ready, we need to do a couple things. So we're going to work on our timer, create a new one. We're going to make sure that it is a one shot. And then we are going to connect to the timeout, create a one-off function, and then jump pressed equals the false. And then we need to add this timer as a child to our scene. And we need to go down to our physics process, and we need to add an else clause to this if statement. Okay, so now we need to do if jump is pressed. We're going to do our velocity.y, going to equal our jump force. Then we're going to set jump pressed to false. Jump buffer time, timer, we're going to stop it. And then if you want, you can add the player particle manager and stop the run particles. This is something that we set up in a previous tutorial. We need to come down here And on this if, we're going to break this up a little bit. So now we're going to break this up into here. We're going to put a colon there, and then we're going to make this an if statement as well. So if one of these two, then they're doing this, our initial coyote time implementation. Otherwise, jump pressed equals a true, and jump buffer timer, we're going to start at jump buffer time. Now let me go play this. You'll be able to see that I'm not even really touching the ground as much. If I keep pressing space, I can immediately jump. Whereas if you go back and look at how we originally had this, there was a little bit of a pause when we hit the ground, but now we can keep jumping. And so that's a really quick implementation of both coyote jump and jump buffering. Feel free to change around the variables, but this is what I found works best for my example. But please let me know in the comments if you found another way to make this work better.